Alright then, kids. Hello and welcome back to what may well be the end of XCOM Enemy Unknown. I am the Black Shadow, and preparations are done. We managed to nail a supply barge that was being used by the aliens, and we have managed to get hold of enough resources from that ship to outfit myself with the last few bits that I wanted before we took on the final part of the game. Our squad is about as good as it's going to get. We've got plenty of equipment, the engineering. We've got tons of stuff here. We've got our mine shield. I've got the blaster launcher. We've got plenty of armor. We're pretty much good to go, everyone. There's nothing more to research. There is nothing more to be done. And with any luck, it'll all be over by Christmas. So, it's going to be a long video. So, let's get going. So, the first thing that we need to do is we must visit the... Oh, of course. I unequipped everyone before... I just took off everyone's equipment, so I suppose you will be I'll give you the stuff that you'll need. There you are. Lovely. There you go. Now I can use the fuel device. Science, everyone. Once the ethereal device is triggered, all forward progress will be stopped. Any current research or foundry products will not be completed. Any injured soldiers in the infirmary will not be healed. Commander, are you sure you wish to proceed? Basically, the last warning, folks. This is your point of no return. If you proceed to use the device, you cannot go back and you must go on to the end of the game. So make sure you are all geared up and ready to go. Which we are. And of course... only one person who can use it.
With each of our major victories, we have encountered incrementally more powerful aliens. After the first alien craft was shot down, they began a campaign of terror. The alien forces were led by a sectoid commander, a powerful psionic creature. Upon capturing the hyperwave beacon, we detected a cloaked ship carrying a being of incredible psionic power. Having captured the device it sacrificed itself to protect, an immense alien ship has now appeared within our atmosphere. We can only assume
that a big being eyes, of mate.
Even greater psionic power is on board this vessel. We have already pushed human evolution so far, and I fear where the next step will take us. Our enemy leaves us with no other choice. A new type of weapon is required.
At long last, you have succeeded where we have failed.
Hello, Mr. Ethereal. It's done. Assault the temple ship. The last objective of the game. So now the device is used. We must now gear up for the end. Anyone else got anything to say? As Varlan gave us the history lesson of what's happened. No, no. There's no skip forward progress anymore. There's nothing left to do but assault the temple ship. It's a big ship, everyone. It's a big map, as I'm sure you can all appreciate. So, let's outfit the squad. Now, whoever you got to use the ethereal device must be in the mission, and they must be the squad leader, folks. I think I just pointed out right now, they are fixed in that position. And they must also... Wow, unable to volunteer, that's weird. Yeah, whatever. So let's gear up the squad for the last fight. So, as I said I wanted, I'm going to have two supports. So, I'm going to have Ravika in. Who I'm going to have... It's going to be Archangel Arm, it has to be. Oops. Medkit, of course. Don't need to worry about arc throwers anymore or anything like that. I don't know if the grenade... Well, saying that, earlier on the grenade might be of some use. Towards the back end, not so sure. But I'll keep that. And we're also going to have... Unfortunately, couldn't get her to Colonel. But it'll be alright. Miss McSpang here. So she will only be able to heal for 6 health instead of the full 10. But that's just... I tell you what, I'm actually going to give you a skill. Now, we're also going to have one heavy with us. Who do I want? Do I want Adkins? He's been here. Or do I want Sam? Extra will would be handy. What have we got abilities-wise? The Shredder Rocket, the Heat Ammo, and the Rocketeer. You've got the same abilities, haven't you? Your will is slightly less, but you have been with me for, like, virtually the whole bloody game. It would be kind of harsh to not bring you along. And you get to play around with the blaster launcher, you lucky boy. It's a strange-looking weapon, but it is pretty damn powerful, everyone. Really, really good. I'm going to enjoy using that. And I might... It is actually tempting. We're going to be dealing with every sort of enemy you can think of. Cheating plating might be of use. Actually, yeah, I'm going to bring it along. I'm going to go with it. And what I'm also going to do, as I was ooming and ahhing about, and I am going to do it, is I am going to bring two snipers with me. And it's probably going to be the French Connection as well. In Killanet and Kizion. I really have thought heavily about bringing Alan Brewster in. Having both of them with squad sight would be awesome. But it would be nice to have the option that Kizzy brings with the snap, with being more portable. It would be of use. And it would be nice to have the diversity, I think. So, I'm going to go with that. Am I happy with the loadout? I think so. There's a couple people, there's a few people I would have loved to have brought along. I mean, I'd have loved to have brought Mecha along, that's for sure. Alan, again, I could certainly justify, and if either of these guys had not made it to this point, you'd have been a guarantee in. And Sam was there just in case. I think a couple people can feel a bit unlucky that they didn't make it, especially not half the people that died on the way here. You know, some of you had your names booked on the plane to this here. There is absolutely no doubt about that. Reaver. certainly had his name booked on that flight. Kira certainly had a great opportunity to make it here. Well, pretty much every support that I had that died before this point had a pretty much a chance to make it here. But this is going to be the squad we've taken on for the very last mission. It's a very long mission, and I need to really not fuck this up. Let's go. Oh, actually, no, before I do that, one last save. There we go. Let's go, everyone.
Touching down.
No briefing from Bradford on this. We finally have the strength to face the Ethereals on their own ship. The future of humanity is at stake. Expect extreme resistance. We must force entry into the Temple ship's bridge, and the volunteer must survive. Volunteer being Mr. Falconer. If Falconer dies, we lose. And as no one else has the gift, we really can't afford to lose everyone. We have a problem. So this can't go wrong. I love how they just let me onto the temple ship though.
You hear our voice, new one. Now listen well.
Yeah, that's the ethereal hive mind.
Long have we watched and waited. So many promising subjects. So many failed efforts. And now, after untold trials, the new one emerges.
Yeah, we're going to get in a lot of communiques from the hive mind, everyone, so I would
I got my eyes on.
I would get a bit used to it. So, as you see here, what I did there is this first area, I'm not even going to show you how big this place is, just assume it's massive. This first area breaks into three different areas. So I'm going to have the snipers going up this central path, and I've split my medics. This is why I love having two medics, everyone. I've split the medics into two, one of each side. One's going to have Falcon, who's got a new ability here, folks. He's got the Rift, which he is allowed to use because he was the one who used the ethereal device. He automatically picks up the Rift, which is a devastating sonic storm. It is a very powerful ability, everyone. And considering that he's got 125 will, it's pretty good. So, let's explore.
I'm on it, Commander. Look sharp, enemies rolling up.
Sectoids. Set to a commander. Okay. As you'll gradually notice as we go through this, folks, we will encounter all the variety of enemies that we have encountered over the course of the game.
Out of the game.
Really need to get some shots off on this damn commander. Oh, he's in a really awkward spot. Well, bitch. Damn. Where's Sox when you need him, mate? Abuse his flush ability. The one time I don't bring him with me. How typical. I see some things haven't changed there, Atkins.
Oh, missed the target.
He's down.
Let's get rid of these damn sectoids. There's not a teleport, is there? No. Okay.
Heading there now. Position confirmed.
Don't think either of them can see him, can you? So I'll get them both on Overwatch, just in case he decides to.
I got my eyes on.
That's not bad. But I would much rather. I might well actually use the Sonic Storm here. Be careful, it's like it's pretty powerful. Let's have some fun. Yeah. He's dead.
The new one faces the earliest effort of the Ethereum ones. The first failure. Though possessed of a certain brilliance, they were marred by their cowardice and frailty, which made them cruel and ultimately useless. Another attempt, this one inspired. Two subjects, each with a glaring weakness, brought together in the hopes of a symbiotic strength. And yet, this newfound power left them devoid of higher thought, lacking in comprehension. Another useless effort.
Yeah. So what this is, this mine, it's like the ethereal sort of saying about all the different things that they've been trying to do with all the, you know, with the, like same with the sectoid, you know, that was their first attempt at sort of, I wouldn't quite say mind controlling or ways like their genetic stuff that they've been doing. It was their first attempt and their first failure. You know, and now they've tried to use all sorts of things, so... Oh, I really did not actually want to trigger them. Fuck it. Right. Gizzy, you really need to kill this thing. Please.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, the spawns of these enemies will be, they don't change particularly. They don't change at all, it's where they spawn. So it's all about trying to get that first strike in, it's very important. Look, in the zone there, that's just, that is why having in the zone as a option is so good. Two squad-sided snipers was certainly up there for thinking, but hell, I mean, that's pretty much is self-justification right there. By the way, there's a five-turn cooldown for using the rift. So, no. Whoa! What was that? Do you like to see some kind of enemy that I didn't see? Bloody hell! What are you guys aiming at?
Not good.
Oh, my dear. Could have been worse. Now, because the fact that this level is so bloody long, you really need to try and avoid taking damage for as long as you can. It is really against all advice. To take damage. There's so many enemies to have to deal with on this level. really, really make sure you take look at everything possible. Why I made sure I brought two supports. Long way to go. Ooh, hello. What's he doing down there?
That's affirmative. Eyes on target.
Just a lone sectoid. Okay. Well, you can die.
X-ray neutralized.
Alright. That's the first section here complete, which is good.
Position
confirmed. So, same again. So for a lot of this level, I'm going to stick with the same groupings as I have done so far.
I'm ready.
If 2x2x2. 2x2x2.
Affirmative.
That's a nice start, at least. The cyber disc can catch you out if you're not prepared for them, but contrary to popular belief, everyone, I have done this before.
All an ass.
Right. Now this is where you really do want to have some good snipers on your team.
Affirmative, moving out.
This second section, oh, it's good times to have good snipers with you.
10-4.
Doesn't mean they're impervious though.
Anything Location like confirmed.
Overwatch.
Just Overwatch here. You guys. Yeah, just Overwatch for the time being.
I've got my eyes on.
I've got my four things as well.
On the move.
You know.
Reloaded.
Four battle scanners, so that'll be of certainly some use. I'll be needing those every now and again. Right. Let's start exploring to the next section. Which, believe me, is nowhere near as docile as it may look on paper.
Moving. Enemy in sight.
The new one
faces. Floaters.
An equally great disappointment. When their organic form failed to evolve, it was given the strength of a machine. Creating this merciless, fearless killer, a fate worse than death.
Well, if anything, that must be a mercy killing. Right, right. Because, you know, he's dead now, and like.
I'm all over it. Positive enemy contacts.
Floater there. Heavy floater, okay. Didn't think I'd trigger the heavy floater.
Oh
yeah, that's good times.
Roger, I've got my
first strike capability. I don't say these things because they sound good on paper. I say it because I fucking mean it.
That's affirmative.
First strike capabilities.
Taken care
of. It's all about this level.
10-4.
Right, okay. We might as well move you forward a bit here, Nats.
Here they come.
Floaters up there. Are gonna get a shot on me.
Cover the
flames. Oh shit, someone's. Oh, you bollocks. Wow. Okay.
Nailed him.
I don't know why exactly he's done that. but I'm willing to work with it.
Hostile neutralized.
Yeah, you are gonna take hits. It is inevitable, folks, but it's just about limiting them as much as you can. Right. I wouldn't mind moving my guys up here.
Roger that. Overwatch.
Just gonna leave them in Overwatch here now. That may look a bit mad, but trust me. That's
okay. I feel, Commander.
Professional. I know what I'm doing. I think.
Nah,
just stay there for the moment. There's not much I can really do.
Got it covered. Overwatch. Aye, aye.
Admittedly, it is a bit better here having two squads sighted. Hello! Hello! The Ethereans have been taking all these species of aliens. All these separate species. And they've been doing all sorts of shit to them. I did know that those Chrises were going to spawn there. All this time, the Ethereans have been looking for, species that they have not declared as failures. And,
Roger that.
Colonel Falcon now being able to use the gift and contact the Ethereum mind, they're like, yeah, that's pretty
I'm
cool
rolling.
Of us. I'd say it's a great success.
Got it covered.
Yeah, sometimes the enemy groups are already around ready to spawn. Sometimes the game will do stuff like that and they'll just spawn them on top of you and it's pretty ugly.
Heading out.
So you gotta be prepared for that.
Overwatch aye aye.
Right. So that'll move us into this section, which is where things will get start getting a little bit more complicated. Been reasonably simple so far. Now, I am going to get Jackie up here just to heal up thingy. I am going to exercise that.
On the move.
Especially, in this one where it's quite easy to get groups a bit isolated. That can certainly happen. So, it's not for that reason.
I got my eyes
just
on
gonna
eyes peeled, Commander.
Not do anything too crazy.
On it.
This next section of progress can be a bit difficult, however.
Overwatch.
That is certainly a truth.
I'm on it, Commander.
Roger,
Dodger.
Luckily,
aye, aye.
No major catastrophes as of yet.
Yes, sir.
Let's just get you guys up to the door.
On my way.
Okay. Look sharp. Enemies rolling up.
Effort. A being of intelligence and exceptional loyalty. Easily adapted to serve our needs. Still, despite such great hopes, they were unable to embrace the gift. Another wasted example.
Hmm. Well, at least the Ethereans are recognizing some of the strength that the Finn men did provide. But ultimately, they couldn't use Sarnix, which I suppose was what they were really after.
Time to motor.
A bit concerned that the pair of these guys are going to have to get poisoned. Oh, never mind. Is going to halt my progress of the sniper's turn, but... well...
understood. Moving out.
We're making pretty good progress, actually, so far. I thought this might take a little bit longer to get through here. But we've done alright so far. We're doing alright.
X-ray spot.
Big man there. Yeah, this happens a lot. They tend to run through. It's really annoying.
That's affirmative. Roger, I've got
and then
my
they,
eyes
like,
on.
Stack up next to the door, and it's like a real fucking
location
mess.
Confirmed. Aye, aye, Commander.
I really should have just stacked someone up on the
solid
damn...
copy.
And just put someone on Overwatch. That would have been useful. But nope! Why would I do such a thing?
I got my eyes on.
You know, does that be intelligent?
Roger, Dodger.
Especially because the next area that the mutons then lead into can be quite dangerous. You start getting and dealing with some of the slightly more serious enemies. Not that chrysalids and fin men aren't, but you know what I mean.
I'm ready.
Alright, now I am gonna reload everyone who needs it.
Let's rock.
I'm on.
As I said, this next area can be dangerous.
Locked and loaded. Ready to rock.
I'm ready.
Also just gives a turn just to let this poison clear out a bit. Right. And I tell you what I'm actually going to do as well. Throw a scanner out. Because I know what bad fucking things are here.
Scanning target area now.
Mutons! And all their friends are around here. And that berserker there is quite dangerous. He can certainly give you some fun and games if you're not ready for it.
Got it covered.
That's
believe me, you've got to be more cautious going through this area than you wager. You really do. If
on
you decide
move.
To just run up these stairs, you can get
I'm on it,
murdered. Actually
Roger
gonna
that.
Wait this turn out.
Roger, I've got my eyes on. That's affirmative.
That's why.
Those who came before them.
Right, okay. Hope I can take out at least one of those targets. That's a good start. Because that gives me the bonus shot here. Now, I've got to be careful if I take this shot on. That's going to commit me to having to kill this guy.
Moving. Enemies in sight.
See what happens here. Ooh, hello.
Cover.
Please kill
plane.
It.
Take it care of.
The problem you have with the armors that are the heavy class sometimes, though. This sort of situation can easily happen. Right, okay, let's, I have to pull back. It's God, you gotta do this sometimes, folks. You've just got to, oh, what if I'd have just used my fucking Archangel armor and flown? Wouldn't have to worry about this damn berserker, because, you know, he ain't like on pogo bloody steel things. Ugh. Damn it. Alright, pull back.
Okay.
Roger. I've got my eyes on.
Now, what do I want to do here?
Headed
so we
now.
Go here. Get this bit of damage. Good
on Overwatch.
Boys, there's a mutilant ran down there, wasn't there, folks? Gonna have to pull back here as well.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Yeah, these stairs are a bit nasty to get up.
On
the best
Overwatch.
Of times. Yeah, you knew exactly what the fuck he was up to. Ooh, you're gonna suppress me? That's novel.
They're moving to flank me.
Here comes a grenade. On the face of things is actually not too bad.
Headed there now. Kill confirmed.
There we go. Bit more like it.
I'm on the move. Moving to Overwatch.
Okay. Let's get
headed
you there,
there.
We're gonna absolutely commit to this.
I'm rolling.
Deal with you first.
Bye bye.
You. Gonna waste this guy. Like it. Okay. Didn't really want to take as much damage as I have. Well.
Heading there now.
Right. Kizzy, I want you to head over here. Because I'm going to want you to go and get healed by Jackie. Especially before we proceed into the next area, which is a very dangerous part. There is a lot of potential for this to go wrong, everyone, so I'll be making use of some of my special abilities here for sure.
I'm on it, Commander.
The Rift is the Rift immune? Yeah, the Rift does more damage against targets with low will and reduced damage against targets with high will. I was checking to see if it's resistant against robotic enemies. It's not officially.
Back online.
Right. Let's touch catch you up here.
Time to cowboy up.
Snipers, I really would rather they stay alive for this.
Roger, I got my eyes on.
Snipers are going to be very, very useful in this next area. So I'm going to get them on these pieces of cover just for the moment. This is just so I can get my, get everyone prepared. My heavy is going to be exceptionally important and vital for this next part as well. So,
aye, aye, Commander.
Just get everyone sort of stacked up, reloaded, and ready to go.
Back in.
Okay. So, what we're going to do is we're going to put both of our snipers onto ghost mode.
Ghosting.
What we're going to do with our snipers, and I hope to God that the robots don't see through this, because there are robots down here. Bad robots.
I'm all over it.
An artificial warrior created to supplement the limitations of the many failures. Crafted with a singular purpose, it ultimately contributes little to our cause. Still, there is hope as a new one approaches.
Sectopods, two of them. No drones, but still two fucking sectopods. And that's, it's a dangerous situation. So I'm just gonna... The idea here is just to get these guys up there and ready. Now, the trick here is getting your troops close enough so that they don't actually trigger the sectopods. I don't want to trigger them straight away.
Heading there now.
I daren't go much closer than this.
I'm all over it.
Now, the plan is I'm going to be using Adkin's shredder rocket here. The only problem with the shredder rocket means that I have to get him to face them for a turn. He can't run up and just fire the rocket, so I have to kind of get this right. I'm actually tempted just to heal him, but I'm not going to.
Overwatch, aye aye.
Roger, I've
remember that the
on.
Moment that these guys come out of ghost mode, these sectopods are going to be a bit pissed. What can I do, shredder rocket rise from here? Of course I can, because I've got a bloody blaster launcher, don't I?
Roger that.
I don't have to do anything crazy.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Of course, because I've got the blaster launcher, I can control where this goes, folks, and you can use this to, you know, it'll plot its own course around corners and all sorts of stuff, folks. I completely forgot about this. So, we're going to send the shredder rocket down to here, and we're going to nail both of these and shred them, which, of course, is very important against double sectopods. That I say, it's a pretty cool weapon, that. It's a pretty cool weapon. Right, so now that they're shredded, we want to do as much damage as we can, and ideally kill them there. One. Oop. That kind of cut itself out there. It does that sometimes, with the way the despawning works. Right, so it's nearly dead, so we want to finish
heading
it off. Alright.
The new one continues to surge. To prove that this was a worthy path, that we were justified in our efforts. This will bring about our redemption.
Right, sets. So the moment you take out the sector pods, folks, you trigger more enemies that need dealing with. And I believe they're Muton Elites?
That's affirmative.
So, yeah.
Scanning.
Not really in the greatest spot here to be dealing with Muton Elites, everyone.
On my way.
On the move.
I feel
need
commander.
To get our guys into some sort of position. Nat from here. I don't know if he'd be able to provide much of a squad site from here. No idea.
Aye, aye, Commander. Enemies in sight.
Yeah, they are elite, I thought so. Right. Oh, that's so beautiful. That's so beautiful. I love this game.
Solid copy.
Roger that. Scanning.
Roger. I've got my eyes on.
Yes, sir. On Overwatch.
Here comes the other one now.
I'll get it next time.
Where exactly he ran, but
heading to that location.
Well, he's taking a reaction shot, and I can't see where from.
That was close.
I still can't see where exactly from.
Affirmative.
He's a bit concerned.
Aye, aye, Commander. Roger, I've got my eyes on.
This is where you can have some problems. Getting up this bit here can be a bit awkward.
Double time.
Gonna run Kizzy up here. There we go. You won't be able to get target.
Roger that. Roger. I've got my eyes on.
Yeah, it's very difficult to move too far forward here. Very difficult.
Scanning.
Have to just take it step by step here. Here he comes.
Damn it. Missed the target.
Wow, Nat's missed.
The target.
Did not expect that. Wow. Well, he was very generous to donate his life there. I didn't quite think he was going to do that. But, well, all donations generously accepted.
I'm on it.
I'm on the move.
Still gotta get up here. I don't know. I don't remember if there's anything actually still up here or not. Could be.
On my way.
I'm not actually quite
sure. I'm on the move. Overwatch. Aye, aye.
There will be a good way for me to actually check. Do that next turn.
Rolling out.
Roger, I got my eyes on.
I'll move Nats in a second.
I'm on the move.
It's pretty safe, everyone. As we lead up to here, folks. This is the final doorway to the final room of the game. There's the throne. The Hive Mind Center. Also, water. So what we're going to do now is we're going to stack everyone onto this sort of nearish this doorway, but not actually on it.
Let's do this.
As I've now got to get this bit right.
Location confirmed.
Spoiler warning. It is not always... It is possible to get this wrong. And people die. I would love for everyone to make it through this. There's no guarantees that that's going to happen.
Stepping off.
It's been a little bit different, actually, because a lot of the time when I end up doing this, I do tend to just do it with two squad site snipers. So having the one within the zone and, you know, and with snapshot is a little different.
I'm ready.
Roger that.
Everyone, so just reload for a moment. We're green that hasn't reloaded.
Back online.
Well, Nats is going to be in this spot here. That is an absolute guarantee. Now. What kind of reach have you got with the rift? How far can you... That's not really what I was trying to find out.
Heading to that location.
How far can you use the rift? What kind of range have you got on this? You've got a... What kind of range? About... That's pretty good. Now, what we would normally do, or what you're supposed to do, is you're meant to come into this room here. And there is, basically, there's several ethereals in here, along with an enemy called the Uber Ethereal, who's been contacting us via the Hive Mind. He's kind of like the leader of the invasion, basically. And they all need to die. Problem is, coming in here and getting surrounded by several Ethereals is a pretty bad spot to be in, everyone. So, for that reason, I am going to not play this game's games, basically.
Got it covered.
So, we're gonna do this slightly differently.
We're green to go.
When I say slightly differently, I mean I am going to play piggy with them.
Okay.
Now, someone is going to have to be a brave soul. You might as well heal up Adam now, thinking about it. Because when this all kicks off, I don't think I'm going to have much opportunity to do much healing. It's all going to get very nasty very quickly. Actually, do you need to be that close? No, you don't. Right, you certainly...
Commander.
So what we're going to do
Overwatch.
Is Kizzy is going to be attempting to draw the enemy in. So let's just run up to here. So this is the hive room here. Now, again, there are areas you could certainly go. You could move up here, you could run up top, and do all sorts of fancy shit in here if you really want to, but I have absolutely no desires to do any of this.
Getting a better look.
That was one strange bounce.
Behold the greatest failure of the Imperial Ones. We who failed to ascend as they thought we would. We who were cast out. We who were doomed to feed on the gift of lesser beings. As we sought to uplift them, to prepare them for what lies ahead.
That is the Uber Ethereal.
The hunt draws to a close. It was not a vain undertaking, but a necessity. As our physical form has grown ineffective, our search for the perfect specimen was driven by our own crippling limitation. And now, at long last,
Did I forget to mention Muton Elites also turn up? Yeah, this is a pretty bad fucking situation, everyone. So everything here needs to die. Along with here, the uber ethereal folks. This guy has got 30 health, I believe he has. No, he's got 20. He's got 25. I think on impossible, I think he's got 30 health. Either way, he is one tough hombre, and he can do whatever he wants. Sonically, he has access to the entire damn book. He even has a strange ability here, folks. Psy Drain. He can drain health from an enemy, from an ally. So, I could shoot. So we're squad site quite nice at this point. Yeah, these enemies are already bloody triggered, so.
Enemy spotted.
Yeah, I know. They're pissed. Ooh, I got double tap. Oh, of course I do. So everything here is now pissed, so. Right. So what we're gonna do is Falconer, I'm gonna get him to use this straight away. And oh no, I thought it was a much bigger area than that. Bollocks. Right. I'm gonna run him up to here. I'm gonna get him to use Psy Inspiration here.
I give you strength.
There we go. So that will help Kizzy out in case they get a lot closer than I thought they would.
Feel, Commander.
Everyone else is just going to wait around here for the moment. And we're going to try and drag the enemy in. Because they are going to want a piece of us, everyone. Whee! By the way, Uber Ethereal, he's got like about 150, 160 wheel or something absurd. You can see these Ethereals, they all want my soul. Oh, fuck. Ow. Don't tell me he can see me. I really gotta get the PC version of this game. I'm gonna be right back. I'll be right back, everyone. Well, folks, nothing like a game crash to bring an anticlimactic end to an LPA. Oh dear. Anyways, I have replayed the mission and brought us back up to this point. I had a funny feeling, you know. I had a feeling that maybe I should save the game just in case something happens, but never mind. Right, so we're going to try this again. Now, what I'm going to do...
No retreat, no surrender.
...is, this time... to try and save Kizzy from getting bloody silenced, is I'm going to give him the, Psy Inspiration straight away. I should probably also
ghost
give him
confirmed.
Ghost straight away. That'd be a good idea.
On the move.
So, like last time, we are going to lob this thing.
Scanners up and running.
Don't think I can skip the cutscene here. No.
Behold,
no, don't think so. Have a look at the ethereal device there in the back. You can see it's doing a lot of stuff. Quite possible that is what is keeping this temple ship afloat, folks. So it is working overtime. Certainly, potentially a device which would control the temple ship. No doubt about that.
For what lies ahead.
You're going down this time, Uber Ethereal. So help me God. Spawn all his buddies. Right. Ooh, I've got targets on both of them today. Okay. I shall certainly take shots at both. Now, do I shoot at one and kill it, or do I shoot both? I'm gonna weaken both here. Oh, he's dead anyways. Okay, well, that was apparently the right decision. Go with that. Okay, so assuming that this game doesn't decide to freeze, I did save the game. I'm pretty sure. Here come little ethereals on their way.
It's getting crowded over here.
Move on down there a bit. Here's the elite. It was Overwatch. Right. We'll get Nats to fire again here. Try and take out the other elite. That'd be good. Damn it.
Missed the target.
Never mind. Right. It is tempting to have at this, but I'm not going to. What I am going to do, though, is what kind of range has Faircon got on a rift? I tell you what, it is actually worth me coming a bit closer. Right, Kizzy, run back.
10-4.
Oh, sorry. Let me just make sure that I did actually save the... Yeah, I did. Good. So we're going to move forward just a little bit.
I'm all over it.
Still being affected by our own Psy Inspiration. Look, 155 will. This is going to do some serious damage. Oh, right, I hadn't used the rift ability on the rerun here, folks. My bad.
And with such great confidence, so skilled with a gift.
See, it's done some nice damage there to the ethereal. Ooh, Silence shot back there. But again, the very high wheel, meaning that it wasn't too effective. Is it actually worth... There is no way. Oh, that would have been so awesome, and you know it. Right, what I am going to do is I am going to throw one of Ruvika's smoke grenades just to give Falconer a hand here, because he might take more Silence shots. Because that will boost his wheel just that extra bit.
Roger that. Roger adding. I've got my eyes on.
Nat's unable to do anything at the moment.
Ready to engage.
Yeah, more damage here. Unfortunately, the mind control, not going to be able to use that again for a while, so I think I'm going to have to, I might have a go at a mind fray here, and then I'm probably going to pull back.
Your nightmare is
yes!
Starting.
Just Sonic Wars here, folks.
I've healed, Commander.
Good stuff. The beauty, if you can get more than one Sonic Soldier, you can certainly have at these ethereals, but as is, kind of dangerous. Yeah, taking plenty of damage now. Gonna have to pull Falconer back. Although I might have a, see if I can't throw a blaster rocket down there first. Hello? I don't want to take out all this cover down the front, though. Because I might be, might want to use some of it, but I think I'm going to have to here. See, the ship just vibrate there. Bloody hell. Hive mind. Not too impressed that I'm going to war with him here. He thought that it would all be over. Not quite.
Man up and get back out there.
See, all of Falconer's abilities there. Every single one of them on recovery there. Just going to pull back. I'm going to get Jackie to heal herself up here as well. Difference between 12 and 15 dealing when you're fighting Ethereals is surprising. So just gonna take it easy for a moment. See if we can't get the enemy to attack us. Surely they get too tempted to have a go. I really want them to have a go. I really do.
Scanning target area now.
There's the Uber Ethereal down there. 25 health. He's got about like 150 will or something.
Roger.
Absurd
I've
as
got
well.
My eyes on.
On Overwatch.
On Overwatch. Moving to Overwatch.
I'm on it.
Basically, we ain't mind controlling it. I had a decent chance to mind control the other Ethereal. That would have been pretty awesome. That's something you don't often get an opportunity to do. Right.
Moving.
Back out we go. More sire, another sire rift, everyone. Sire rift the whole area. Bound to piss him off. Oh dear, sorry,
got
folks.
It. Roger, I've got
on
my eyes on.
Gonna move Atkins just a little closer.
Eyes peeled, Commander.
Try and see if I can't, you know, get a little bit better position to fire another blast rocket from. Hello. There goes the rift. Didn't prove very effective, ultimately. But it did reveal more of the positions. Ship shaking again.
Aye, aye, Commander.
I'm moving our forces forward, folks. Clearly, I think it's gonna end up resulting in a. It looks like it's gonna end up resulting in fisticuffs, everyone.
Heading out.
Roger, I got my eyes on.
So, sigh inspiration, everyone.
No retreat.
We're gonna win! Oh, Ravika, I didn't get to. Sorry.
Moving to Overwatch.
Moving to Overwatch.
We're gonna advance forward and we're gonna wipe out this alien scum. Let's go!
I'm rolling.
Wherever the hell they've gone, that is.
Okay.
Remember, it's only Ethereals. We've taken out the elites, so we don't have to worry about, cover in a way. Still would be nice to have some, just so it make me feel a little better, but
I'm on it, Commander.
It'd also be nice to know where the hell the Ethereal's gone. Oh, there he is. Hello. Sir. I do say, sir.
Solid copy.
That shit about trying to end humanity, that shit's just not cool.
I'm about to start keeping score.
Bye. Oh dear. Looks like killing the Uber Ethereal, maybe not the best idea.
Itself is behaving like a dying star, becoming a black hole.
Because that's logical.
At this distance, the Earth will be consumed.
Well, Shubby, you didn't know a damn thing about this game. And now look where we are. If it isn't a hero's tale, I don't know what is.
Central, I'm bugging out. The package is not on board. Waited as long as I could, sir.
Sir, the alien ship is in motion.
What direction? What direction?
Up.
Of course, connected to the hive mind, he knows what's going to happen. Volunteer makes the ultimate sacrifice. And that, everyone, aboard our Silent Sky Ranger, means we win. There's a whole host of stats available to you folks, but we have won it! We have won! We have defeated the alien scum who dared to threaten humanity. Threaten humanity? Either way, we sent their home with their tails between their legs. Took 287 days, 41 battles. It's kind of cool when you beat the game, so it has you the stats you have. There is world collected averages, though some of them clearly don't quite work. Soldiers lost 14. Certainly above the average, folks. There's no question about that. Did pretty good on some of those timings there, folks. It took four months to clear the alien base. The Ethereal device we did recover pretty quickly. A lot of people, people start researching the Sonic Soldiers before dealing with, like, the Hyperwave device and, dealing with the Overseer ship, whereas I tend to go the other way around, but that's just me. So 41 battles fought, we won them all, killed 479 aliens, average shot percentage 64.7%. Wow, 223 one-shot kills and 10 one-shot deaths. Now, bear in mind that we lost 14 soldiers. 10 of them died in one shot. Sounds about right, though, doesn't it? Sounds about right. 175 days till our first colonel. That was certainly far longer than I wanted it to be. That really hurt in us in the mid-game. Ray really took some punishment because we just couldn't get a colonel quickly enough so I could get a Don't Dar Me. That really hurt. Just the one Sonic soldier for us in this campaign's all we found. And if we'd have lost him, we'd have had a problem. So yeah, all the rest of it, pretty good here, folks. 175 days for the first firestorms was about right. 7 workshops. Well, we built quite a lot. Nothing much particularly there. We captured 5 species of alien, which wasn't bad. We earned a total of 17,000 credits. We spent 15 of those. Recovered 1,000 Illyrium. Recovered 2,200 alloys. Ain't bad. We received 10,000 credits from funding, 4 and a bit from the grey market. Yeah, days until second satellite, 28. Third satellite there, first continent. All pretty good, folks. And that, everyone, is the end of the game. We win. Thank goodness for that. The XCOM project has officially been a grand success. And we have seen the backs of these aliens. For now, at least. So, while one of the longest credit sequences in the history of man begins, it is a really, really long credit sequence. Well, I suppose I better start by saying that I hope you guys all enjoyed XCOM. It has been quite a bit of an ambitious project, folks. Certainly not a style of game which I often LP, though I do certainly enjoy. And certainly a game that I have been very interested in LPing for quite a while, for sure. But I was always conscious about when I wanted to LP it, purely because this LP was only ever going to be half what it could be, you know, if I didn't manage to get some people to join in with the LP, folks, with character submissions. You know, I mean, you know, you could go through this game and just roll with whatever character names that it gives you, but it just doesn't quite mean the same, does it, folks? You know, and you could go through and I could put in the names of all, like, my close friends, confidants and allies, but, you know, how can you guys enjoy that? You can't, so. So as far as that is concerned, folks, I have to certainly give a huge thank you to all you guys who sent in character submissions into this LP and made it so much greater than what it would have been otherwise. I was terrified. I'd asked for, like, submissions to get, like, maybe, I don't know, like, 10, a dozen, something like that. But I got a really, really good response. Not everyone managed to get into the LP. For those of you that didn't, and there was only very few people who didn't actually get a submission into the game, I really do apologise. You know, I said at the start, not everyone was going to get in. You know, and unfortunately, unlucky few. But I mean, as far as everyone who did, I do want to thank everyone who sent in a submission. I mean, I've got the list here, folks, and I'm going to name every one of them. We got the very top of our list, DJ Shubby04, the man who didn't know a thing about the XCOM games or the XCOM story or what it was all about, who got rolled in as the very first soldier in the game, one of the very first free soldiers out of the beginning mission, and ended up being the key instrument to saving humanity. Oh, if you've not had a good run through this game, Chubby, then I don't know what you're expecting. You have had one hell of a run through this. You've been absolutely fantastic, and I hope you've enjoyed the part that you have played in this LP. It's been absolutely fantastic having you around. Abraham Falconer, face of XCOM, everyone. Killernats, of course. Killernats is one of our lead snipers at the end of the game. Did really good for us. Squid 81 was Captain Alan Brewster, got him from Major. You're unlucky to have not made the main party to make the last game. I really was tempted to bring in two squad-sided snipers, but I'm very glad I brought in Kizzy. You know, with the snapshot and in the zone, it was just nice to have the variants. Kiro Diamonds, of course. How can we forget Kiro? The poor son of a bitch who ran through every single life I think he could have ever have dreamt up, and unfortunately finally met his end to a muton. But you were great entertainment nonetheless. King Shreikle, or Zweihandler, as you guys might know him as, had a couple of submissions, but was one of the unlucky few to actually not make it into the LP, although he has watched along with the LP. I hope you've enjoyed it. Who else we got going down the list? Maggie Hart, one of our pretty useful mid-game supports. You were lucky in a way not to make it to the end of the game. I mean, pretty much like every single support class that I had in this campaign could have made it to the end of the game and would have probably have made the raid. Oh, dear. Trivial Tree, of course, with Kizzy Yong there, who proved very, very useful at the end. Was a great decision, putting you as a snapshotting sniper proved really flexible at the end. That was really good. Marios UK, also known as Major Sox, who I hope you really enjoyed it. I know we had a bit of fun with your name and that sort of thing, but believe me, I've enjoyed having you for that. I hope you've enjoyed the LP. Metroid Fan 2612, again, another one of the unlucky people who didn't actually get a submission in. You were unlucky. He gave two submissions out of interest. And he'd actually submitted to get either Craig Wilmore or Mark Cook from the X-Files game into the LP. I'd absolutely loved to have done that. I've started amassing all of the submissions. That was one of my favourite entries, actually, was seeing Craig Wilmore come in. That was one of my favourite entries. I really wanted him to get rolled in, but it didn't happen, unfortunately. Ziggy1427 with the Big Bad Wolf. We was a very, very capable sniper for us early in mid-game. Unlucky to have not made the distance. Lying Secrets, or Grey Shadow. You got in, didn't you? I'm sure you did, somewhere. I can't remember now. Heratura with Mecha Cheshire. Again, quite unlucky to have not made the end. The end raid, but you were like first substitute basically. If I would have only had the one support, I'd have quite possibly have put you in and just given you a med kit anyways. And I've got to admit, giving you the that sort of light plasma setup I gave you, I think was absolutely awesome. I'm gonna remember that for later. Bateman, of course, we remember him as Peter Bateman. The man who got absolutely slaughtered by that Finn man in the council mission. So unlucky. The 1 in 100 shot, that was brutal. Also had a second submission as well for Mr. Elisif Ragnarsson, who I don't remember got in. Chris Reaver, I hope you're still watching. I know you it's been a while since you passed in the LP, but my goodness me, you were so useful early to mid game. You were probably like one of the two, three most useful troops that I had in my squad, and I would say even throughout the entire LP put together, you were probably in the top five. You know, you did a hell of a lot for the team, and it really hurt when I lost you. Crazy Flipper with Ruvika Idanova, who of course was there at the end. Was very useful. You had quite a good run, actually. Truth be told, giving you the combat drugs for the smoke was an interesting twist, and I thought it was quite useful, actually. Chrono Marine with Miss Kira Orton, again one of the big early game names to have fallen, and that hurt a lot as well. You had a really, really promising future ahead of you in the XCOM project, and it got cut painfully, painfully short. Edgehead 62888 with Jackie McSpankett, who of course got in there on the second attempt. Awesome dude. Gotta thank him certainly for the legend that was Leroy Jenkins, who had an incredible run in the game. Was our first major, our first dead major who died on the alien base mission to Chrysalids. That really hurt. I didn't need that. And also for bringing in Sam Starfruit towards the end to keep the tradition going and to keep the spirit going. Hackard and Edgemaster, who I know has been watching plenty over the course of time on this channel. Another one of the unlucky people to have not met, got a submission in. With Havel Tank was going to be the guy's name. So I do apologise for that. As well to Raven Dark. Did Raven Darkshade get in? Can't remember. I don't remember you getting in. If you did, I do apologise. That was it. There was only like three. Damn it! This credit sequence is so long. My screen actually went dark. But the credit sequence is so long, it takes forever. And finally, Killer 11947 for Adam Adkins. The heavy who went in from virtually the start of the game to the end. Over 50 kills to his name over the course of the campaign, folks. Pretty awesome stuff. Thank you all. Thank you all so, so much for putting your submissions into the LP and for making it such a fantastic game. It's been a lot of fun LPing, and I hope you've all enjoyed it. Now, before we end, there is one thing which I suppose does need quickly discussing. As I have been asked many times about this, and over the course of the LP, and I said that I will answer it now. And that is regarding several people asking me if I'd be interested in doing one more run with XCOM, and running with XCOM Enemy Within. Now, XCOM Enemy Within is an expansion pack for XCOM Enemy Unknown, although it is actually its own standalone game in some versions, which is a bit stupid. The game brings in its own various new features into the game. Everything from there's new missions and weapons and sort of thing to new concepts. There is meld, which is a new substance. There's genetic modifications. There's a whole variety of bits and pieces that gets brought new to the game, folks. And I had been asked by several people if I would be interested in running one more time XCOM, but with Enemy Within rules. Now, I've not ruled it out at all. And it's as simple as this, folks. If there's a lot of people here that would love for me to do it and to run Enemy Within, I will do an Enemy Within run. It won't be now. It'll probably be like later on in the year, like some point maybe come the winter, because we've had XCOM for 2 months, folks. I need a break from the fucking miserable percentage rolls that this game has thrown at us, folks. I need a break from it. But if people here would like to see a Enemy Within run, folks, and I know that coming a few months' time, when I say, yep, we're gearing up for Enemy Within, I'm going to get more character submissions and all that sort of stuff and jazz, then I think we can probably say that XCOM Enemy Within, certainly a project for the future, folks. So let me know if you'd be interested in that, folks, and if we get a lot of people saying yes, then I will certainly put it in the diary for the back end of the year, folks. I will certainly look at an XCOM Enemy Within run. Why do I want to go through all this again? Am I mad? I must be. Any rate, folks, that is going to be the end of the video, and that is going to be the end of this series. So I thank you all so much for watching. I hope you've all enjoyed it. You've certainly helped me enjoy this game far more than I would have thought I might. I can't even speak. Bloody hell. But yeah, that's going to be all. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your submissions. Thank you for everything you've done for the LP. Thank you for supporting it. And I suppose I will catch you guys down the line. Take care.